Hi guys, and welcome to the next video of this entire series where we are discussing Office 365 Exchange Online concepts. Now, in this particular video, I will be discussing what are the mailboxes in Exchange Online. If you have watched the previous video, in the last session, we discussed what type of groups we have in Office 365 and how those groups work. We discussed how you can use those groups and how membership of those groups work. Now, in this particular video, I will be discussing what is a mailbox and what are the users' mailboxes in Exchange Online and what are the shared mailboxes and how they work. And we will be talking about all the attributes that a particular mailbox has. Now, to understand what mailbox is, a mailbox is a storage space which is allocated to a user account so that they can store their emails and they can store their calendar items. Now, to understand what a user mailbox is, let's assume that I have created a user account in Office 365 Admin Center under active users, right? So as of now, this account doesn't have a mailbox, right? I have just created an account and I have assigned a display name or username Bob Ross, and I have assigned username or user principal name for this particular account, which is bobross@domain.com. Now, with the help of this username, this particular account, Bob Ross, can log into portal.office.com. But when he will log in, he will not be able to see any of these services which are provided by Office 365. The reason is, as of now, there is no license assigned to this particular account. Now, if I assign the license, all of these services which are part of this license, those services will be provisioned for this user account. Now, let's assume that I have assigned Exchange Online Plan 2 license for Bob Ross, right? So Exchange Online Plan 2 is a license which provides you 100 GB of mailbox storage space. So once this license is assigned, 100 GB user mailbox will be provisioned for Bob Ross user account. Now this user will be able to send and receive emails from his mailbox, and he will be able to create meetings from his calendar. And once this mailbox is provisioned for this user account, he will be able to log into Outlook and in OWA using his user principal name and his password. And from Outlook and OWA, he will be able to send and receive emails, right? Now, this is the user mailbox. Now, to understand what a shared mailbox is, you can create a shared mailbox directly within Exchange Admin Center. I will show you this practically. So to create a shared mailbox, you go to Exchange Admin Center, and then you create a new shared mailbox. You assign a display name, you assign an email address, and you mention all of the attributes which are required to create a shared mailbox, right? Now, once a shared mailbox is created, this shared mailbox will be able to send and will be able to receive emails. And if anyone who has full access permission on this particular shared mailbox, he will be able to create meetings as well, right? Now, when you create a shared mailbox, by default, the storage space which is allocated to a shared mailbox, that is 50 GB. And if you want to increase this storage space, if you want to assign more storage space, more than 50 GB, let's say 100 GB, then you need to assign a particular license which provides 100 GB mailbox. So let's say if you assign Exchange Online Plan 2 license to this shared mailbox, which provides 100 GB of mailbox. So once this license is assigned, this shared mailbox size will increase to 100 GB. Now, if you create a shared mailbox in Exchange Admin Center, and if you go to Office 365 Admin Center under Active Users, you will see a similar account created for this particular shared mailbox. The reason is, when you create a shared mailbox, an associated account is also created in Office 365 Admin Center under Active Users. And that account will have the same attributes that you have given to this shared mailbox in Exchange Admin Center when you created this mailbox. You will be able to see all the similar attributes for this account as an active user within Office 365 Admin Center. Now, why we need a shared mailbox? So let's assume that I have these three users, right? And these three users need a common space where they can send emails and where they can create meetings so that every single user should have access to those emails and every single user should have access to those calendar meetings, right? Now, these three users have their own mailboxes. They can log into OWA, they can log into Outlook client, and they can see their mailbox and they can see their folders of the mailboxes. Now, if these users need a common space for that, we can use a shared mailbox, right? So what a shared mailbox does, once you create a shared mailbox, these users can add this shared mailbox in their Outlook and OWA. Now, what will happen? Any user who will send email to this particular shared mailbox, all of these three users will receive that email in that particular shared mailbox, which is added in their Outlook client or in OWA. Now, to achieve this, what you do, you create a shared mailbox and then you assign full access permission on this shared mailbox for these three users. And once this full access permission is assigned for these three users on this shared mailbox, after that, these users will be able to add this shared mailbox in their Outlook and in OWA. So like they can see their own mailbox, they can see inbox, sent items, deleted items, junk folder of their own mailbox. Similarly, they will be able to see the entire mailbox of shared mailbox as well within their Outlook and OWA. So this is how you can create a common space or a common mailbox if multiple users need access for that particular common mailbox. Now, let's say you have a user and this user is going to send an email to this shared mailbox. Now, if any user will send email to this shared mailbox, these three users already have access to this shared mailbox in their OWA. So what will happen? This email will be reflecting within the shared mailbox, which is added in their OWA or Outlook below their mailbox, right? Now, let me switch to my browser and let me show you how a user mailbox and a shared mailbox works. So in order to create a user mailbox, you need to create a user account first. You will go to your Office 365 Admin Center, then you will go to Active Users. And within Active Users, you will create a new user account. Now, let's say if I create a user account here, I will assign him certain values. And then I will assign a password for this account. Okay, now here you need to assign a license to this particular account, which has a license. For example, if I assign Office 365 E3 license, and if I go to services, which are included within this particular license, here you can see Exchange Online Plan 2 Plan 2 service is included within this license. So if I assign this license to a user, a mailbox of 100 GB will be provisioned for this user account. Now click on Next and then click Finish Adding. This user account is created, and within a couple of minutes, a mailbox of 100 GB storage space will be allocated for this particular user account, which is user C. Now, if you want to see whether a mailbox is provisioned for this particular user or not, you can go to this user account properties from Active Users. And here you can click on Mail. Under Mail tab, you can see we are preparing a mailbox for the user. So as of now, mailbox is not provisioned. So it can take a couple of minutes. There is another way to verify if mailbox for user C has been provisioned or not. For that, you can go to Exchange Admin Center You can go to recipients and then go to mailboxes. Now here you can see that user C is not reflecting here. So mailbox for user C is still not provisioned. Same can be verified from old Exchange admin center as well. From recipients, you can go to mailboxes. And here you can see this user is not reflecting yet. Okay, so now it is reflecting. The mailbox is provisioned for this user now. If I refresh, I should be able to see here as well. Okay, this one is taking time. The other way to verify is from PowerShell. Now in PowerShell, you can run command get-mailbox and make sure you are already connected to Exchange Online module before you run any command for Exchange Online. So I'm already connected. And if I run this command, I should be able to see all of the mailboxes. And if I want to verify a mailbox for only one particular user, then you need to run command get-mailbox and the name of that user account. Press enter. Here you can see the 99 GB of the mailbox has been provisioned for this particular account. Now this 99 GB is a prohibit send quota, which means that once this mailbox space will be consumed for 99 GB, this user will not be able to send emails from his mailbox. So as of now, this user has 100 GB of mailbox assigned, right? Now, in order to create a shared mailbox within recipients, go to shared and then click on this plus icon. From here, you can create a shared mailbox. So here, let's say I will be giving a name here. Let's say test shared mailbox. I will assign an email address for this shared mailbox. And here you can assign permissions if you want, and you can click on save. So it says you haven't granted anyone permission to receive or send emails from this shared mailbox. I do not want to send it now, so I'll simply click on yes. And now Office 365 is creating this shared mailbox and it is ready to use. Okay, so now this shared mailbox is created and now I will be assigning full access permission on this shared mailbox for users so that those users can access this shared mailbox from their OWA and Outlook. So for that, I can assign full access permission either from Exchange Admin Center and from PowerShell as well. So I will show you first how you can assign full access permission from Exchange Admin Center. To assign full access permission, double click on the shared mailbox. And these are the properties of this mailbox. And then go to mailbox delegation. Here you will see two permissions, full access and send as. I will be discussing all these permissions in depth, and that will be in upcoming sessions. For now, we will be discussing only full access permission. So under full access, click on plus icon. And here you will be able to see all the users that you have in your organization. From here, you can select the users for whom you want to assign full access permission on this shared mailbox. So I have added user A and user B here, right? And I will be adding admin account as well. I'll click OK, and then you can click save. Now I will be showing you how you can do it from PowerShell also. So let's say I want to assign permission to user A, and for that the command will be add-mailbox-permission-identity. In identity, you will have to mention the name of the shared mailbox or the email address of the shared mailbox. So my shared mailbox name is test shared mailbox. Right. Now, after that, you need to use switch, which is user. User will be the one who needs full access permission on this shared mailbox. So I will be assigning permission for user A. And then the switch will be access rights. Access rights will define what sort of permission do you need? So I want to assign full access permission. Now, the last switch that you need to use here, that is inheritance type. Inheritance type is when you are assigning a permission on a mailbox, by assigning this switch, this will inherit that permission on all of the folders of that particular mailbox. So that is the reason we use inheritance type all, so that all of the folders of that particular mailbox will inherit this particular permission. So from here, you can hit enter, and this particular permission will be assigned to user A, right? And now let me show you, once we add these permissions, how you can add a shared mailbox in your mailbox. Now here you can see that three users have permission on this particular mailbox: user B, user A, and Amit Kumar, who is the admin account of this particular Office 365 tenant. Now, if I go to my OWA for Amit Kumar or admin account, here I can see my on mailbox. This is my inbox, this is the drafts, and this is the sent, and all of the folders that I can see here. Now, to add the shared mailbox, you need to right click on folders and then click on add shared folder, right? And from here, you need to look for that mailbox. Copy the email address and paste email address here and click add. Now here, I can see test shared mailbox at 365conceptslabs.onmicrosoft.com. This is the email address of this particular shared mailbox. I also have access to another shared mailbox, which is ABC shared. And this is the mailbox for this particular shared mailbox. So as I can see my own mailbox, I can see all of the folders of my mailbox. Similarly, I can see the all of the folders of a shared mailbox. But to achieve this, you need to assign, you must have full access permission on that particular shared mailbox. Now, if anyone will send email to this email address of the shared mailbox, that email I will be able to see here under inbox of shared mailbox. So similarly, whosoever has full access permission on this shared mailbox will be able to see all these emails within the shared mailbox in their Outlook profile or within their OWA. So now we have discussed what is a mailbox, and we have discussed what is a user mailbox and what is a shared mailbox. We have also discussed how a shared mailbox is used as a common mailbox where multiple users need access for a particular mailbox. Now, in the next session, I will be discussing what is online archiving or what is in-place archiving. I will be showing you how online archiving works. We will be discussing what sort of licenses you are required if you want to use online archiving in Exchange Online. And I will be showing you how you can enable online archiving for your mailboxes. So if you have learned something new from this particular session, please write in comments and please subscribe to the channel. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching the video. Take care.